This is an offline map viewer that works on Raspberry Pi 02W. I have already loaded the map data and it draws an offline map with the latitude and longitude of the country location obtained by GPS. Of course, an internet connection is not required to receive any GPS information. However, internet connection is generally required to receive map data from a server. If you have the map data in advance, you can pin your location on the map on ePaper without an internet connection. This is what I'm doing here. What you are looking at now shows how it is displayed on the ePaper depending on the zoom level. The maximum zoom level in this system is 19. You can get higher level map data by using other map services, but as you know, most of them require an API key. In my script, instead of using API key, the maximum zoom level is 19, which means it's using public data. One more thing I want to mention is the Python script I made allows you to prepare two types of maps. Sometimes satellite images can be much more useful than regular maps, such as trails, hills, and mountains where there are no regular roads. That's why I made a script that allows you to select a regular map or satellite image and create a local map. And here's the best part. Once you've downloaded the map tiles, everything runs completely offline. Whether you are out hiking, biking, or exploring areas without any cell signal, your current GPS location is still displayed on the ePaper screen in real time, overlaid on either a standard or satellite map. You don't need to worry about a data limit, signal drops, or app restrictions, just pure GPS plus local map data on a lightweight Raspberry Pi system. In the previous video, I tested each component individually. I connected the GPS module and confirmed it was receiving valid location data, all visible through the serial console. Then I connected the ePaper head to the Raspberry Pi and used an example Python script to display content on the ePaper, verifying that both the hardware and driver setup worked correctly. Today, we are going to take it one step further by preparing offline map data so you can see your GPS location right on a map even with zero internet connection. As you can see on the left screen, it's not a bad idea to display your current location based on the satellite map. Also, the reason I keep working is that the screen only updates when there is a sudden distance differences. I will come back to this later. I prepared this offline map downloader for this project. This is a Python application based on Flask, and it is a very, very simple web application. After cloning this project, you can run it right away by just installing the Flask and request package in Python 3. When you visit the localhost, you will see a map screen like this in your web browser. The usage is also very intuitive. First, find the area you want. After pressing the square button on the top left, drag the desired area on the screen. You can select the minimum maximum zoom level that is best for your map. Press the download button to download the map. The tile type can be selected between zip and MB tiles. Zip has map data in folder format. MB tiles has data in SQL format. The only difference is how to access the image data of the map, but in the end, it is based on the same data. I saved the map data as MB tiles because I'm going to use the MB tiles type in the map viewer script. As mentioned earlier, this can download not only normal maps, but also satellite maps. You can prepare both normal maps and satellite maps for the same area. Next, prepare the offline map viewer. This is an offline map viewer for ePaper. If you leave this, you can learn how to draw map data on the ePaper. One thing to keep in mind is that we will have all different hardware modules. If your ePaper or GPS module is different than mine, this code will need to be updated accordingly. This GitHub is already cloned on my Raspberry Pi. Copy the map files created in the previous step from my Mac to my Raspberry Pi. You can check the map files now. In the previous video, we were able to verify the ePaper works well by running the example script using WebShare's code. Since there's no PIP package for this e-paper, we need to use this library. I copied this to the folder I'm currently working in. It's good to go. You can check the required arguments by checking the help. You can run the script with the path to the map file to load, the zoom level, and the minimum delta distance for the update. I'm currently in an indoor space like a warehouse, so the GPS readings are relatively inaccurate. In order for the screen to update, the distance difference from the previous position to the current position must be at least 1 meter, otherwise the screen will not be redrawn. This minimum refresh distance can be changed through the argument. As you can see in the right console, we are currently seeing a difference of more than 1 meter, so it's redrawing the map data centered around the new location. Because it is indoors, the error range of the location data obtained from the GPS module increases. The last action is to register this script as your service. Then, whenever the system reboots, this script will automatically run. That's pretty convenient. What I have created doesn't currently include any input devices, so there's no way to rerun this script if the system reboots. That's why this is so necessary. ePaper Map is definitely a very interesting project. I'm sure you will like this too. I think it's possible to develop the ePaper Map project further. It'll be a much more effective project if it has a button to change the zoom level and map style. And also, I think it'll be faster to pin the current location if it only updates the points that have moved instead of redrawing the entire screen every time. We need to think more about how to make this project more effective. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.